Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to be showing you the various types of downloadable content that's available for the Rock Band 3 video game on Nintendo Wii. First of all, once you enter the music store, you have this menu: newest songs, popular songs, recommended for you, Rock Band Pro, and Browse. If you want to see all the songs that are available for the game, you go to Browse. Right now, as of this date, there was 1,905 songs available for purchase. So let's go in here. Now you have two selections here, three. You have all Rock Band songs and Rock Band Network songs. What Rock Band Network songs are is it's essentially music that's produced by independent bands who submit their music to Rock Band, and what they do is they get the community to chart it, to create the music that you will play with your instruments in the game. So as of this date, Rock Band Network songs, there was 159 available, Rock Band songs 1,746, and all 1,905. Like I stated before, to browse all music, you would essentially take all. Now you could sort by artist, song name, genre, decade, difficulty, newest songs, popular songs, albums, and packs. Let's do it by artist. Here you have a listing of a range, if you will, like for example between AUT and BET. As far as artists goes, you could browse those songs, but not to fret. If you go into one menu, you're not locked to those to that menu. You could then navigate forward and backward to a previous or subsequent grouping through the next and previous buttons. So I'm going to go to BLI. It's to show you an example that I found. Okay, well, I'll begin with this. Why not? What you have in the corner is you have the available instruments to play. Now, a standard Rock Band song, those that are available to Rock Band, Rock Band 2, and so on, will have the following instruments. Well, for the sake of differentiation, we'll call these plastic guitars. What I mean by plastic guitars, I mean the 5-button configuration with the 5-fret button configuration with the clicker for the strum bar. And when I refer to real guitar, what I'm referring to is a Rock Band Pro guitar, either the Fender Mustang Pro or the Fender Squire Stratocaster. Okay, so in the top left corner, going down, you have fake guitar, plastic guitar, fake bass, regular drum. Now, as I mentioned in a previous video, Rock Band 3 converts any downloadable contact song, into Pro Drum mode. So, as you can see here, the first drum you encounter is the standard drum, the 4-pad drum. If you move over to the right, you have a Rock Band Pro drum category. Now, if you're wondering what these little icons are, they represent difficulty. Essentially, it's on a scale from 0 to 5. 0 means it's barely difficult. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you even have a 6 difficulty where the 5 icons turn into red hearts. In that case, it's extremely difficult. Okay, so like I said, your standard Rock Band 2 song will have plastic guitar, plastic bass, regular drum, pro drum, and your standard vocals. Now, if you find a pro song is created specifically for Rock Band 3 or Green Day Rock Band as far as vocal harmonies go. Let me try to find one real quick. Here we go. There you go. Now this is a Rock Band Pro song, available for Rock Band 3, as well as plastic guitar, plastic bass, regular drum, and pro drum, and regular vocals. You also have what's over to the right, vocal harmonies, which means you're using more than one microphone for more than one vocal singer, if you will. And of course the difficulties indicated. You have your standard keyboards. What standard keyboards are is it's using the keyboard, the keytar, whatever, except only playing a 5-color combination. Over to the right, you have Pro Keyboards. Now, Pro Keyboards is when using the full keyboard as if playing piano. It's rather difficult. However, there's difficulty increments that you could choose, of course. And in the top right corner, you have Pro Guitar and Pro Bass. Once again, these are the instruments that have real strings, real guitar strings, or multiple guitar frets, if you will. Once again, the Fender Mustang Pro by Mad Catz, or the Fender Squire Stratocaster. So there you go. Now, the way pricing works, I'm going to move out a bit here. Pricing is always indicated in the right corner. A pack is listed with its title. Here it would be Blink 182 Pack 01. And under that heading, you'll have three songs. The three songs included in the pack, you could either buy them individually for 200 Wii points each, or you could buy the pack for, in this case, 550 Wii points each. Now, the advantages, of course, is that you're saving essentially 50 cents. If you need to know the scale, 200 Wii points is the equivalent of $2. So 550 Wii points would be $5.50 US. If you're in Europe, the translation is 1 for 1 for the euro. So 200 Wii points would be 200 euros, 550 Wii points would be 5 euro 50. I don't know what the denomination is. Anyway, there you go. So that's how you sort, that's how you differentiate. For the most part, songs are available in denominations of $1. These are generally songs from lesser-known artists. There's $2 songs, which are better-known artists. There are packs which range from anywhere, probably from 350 Wii points to, who knows, 1,100 Wii points, 1,200 Wii points. I couldn't tell you how far it goes. Now, when it comes down to buying Pro songs, it's rather misleading, and that's unfortunate. But I want to show you this. If you notice here, there's no price indicated for the song Up All Night. It just reads Upgrade Available. Now, why does it read Upgrade Available? Originally, it was listed as so. Or as so, I should say. Nah, these are no good examples. Anyway, let me try to find another one. Da-da-da-da-da. Here, this will do as an example. Damn It by Blink 182. Damn It is 200 Wii points, and it lists that it has Pro Guitar and Pro Bass, which is essentially, once again, the Fender Squire Stratocaster guitar controller or the Fender Mustang Pro by Mad Catz guitar controller. It's only listed as 200 Wii points, but this is rather misleading. As it would turn out, I'm going to go to the song that I bought, Up All Night. Here. This song shows that it features every single available instrument for the game, and at the time it was only 200 Wii points. So I went ahead and purchased and thought, you know, why not? 200 Wii points, all that gameplay? Good deal. No. The way it works is, for your standard 200 Wii points, you get fake guitar, fake bass, drums, pro drums, if available, keyboards, if available, pro keyboards, vocals, and if available, vocal harmonies. Pro guitar and pro bass, essentially, Fender Mustang Pro or Fender Squire Stratocaster require an extra 100 Wii points in order to buy what they call the Pro upgrade. So there you go. Essentially, for 200 Wii points, you get plastic guitar, plastic bass, drums, pro drums, vocals, vocal harmonies if available, keyboard if available, pro keyboard if available, for real guitar and real bass, What you need to do is you need to shell out another 100 Wii points. So essentially $3 to get all of these instruments, or $2 to get most of the instruments without the real guitar and real bass. Rock Band has claimed that the reason they charge more for pro instruments and pro upgrades is because it takes a lot more effort and a lot more manpower in order to chart the chords, in order to play the real guitar and real bass, and that's why they charge more. So there you go, that's essentially how you go through the Rock Band music store on Rock Band 3, choosing songs and what have you. See, once again, as I was saying, at the end of each grouping, there's next set and previous set, which will bring you into the next category. I was in BIF to BLI, which has 61 songs in it, by the way. If I were to choose next set at the end of that listing, it would bring me down to BLO to BOS. And that's the way you sort. I always choose to sort by all and go through the list. I like doing that. For those who would rather, how could I say that, specify or limit their search results to certain categories, recommended for you, I guess, is based on the music you've already bought. Popular songs are ones that are frequently downloaded, I'd imagine. Newest songs are songs that you have not seen since the last time you visited the Rock Band music store. I can't tell you exactly how it sorts. I'm reluctant to use something that limits me from seeing everything. Rock Band Pro, of course, you could sort between Pro Guitar, Pro Bass, each have 181. Pro Keys, which has 306, and Vocal Harmonies, which has 357. Now, it's interesting to note that there are often songs that, as for a pro component aside from the pro drums, it's not out of the ordinary to find a song with regular Rock Band 2 configuration plus vocal harmonies, or regular Rock Band 2 configuration with no vocal harmonies but with pro keys. It's tricky like that. You have to look around and make sure you look at that little chart in the bottom right corner, which shows what you're getting for your purchase. From what I could tell, those songs that have no vocal harmonies, no pro keyboard, or no keyboard, I should say, no pro guitar and no pro bass, will also work in Rock Band 2, whereas, the songs that have those components will only work in Rock Band 3, should they have vocal harmonies, pro keys, pro bass, and or pro guitar. It could have any combination of these, and it'll be exclusively a Rock Band 3 DLC, save for the Green Day songs. The Green Day songs are compatible in the Rock Band 2 video game, although they support vocal harmonies. Vocal harmonies do not work in Rock Band 2. It's not a feature of the game. Well, there you go. I hope this shed some light on something. I hope this could help somebody. I mean, it's pretty straightforward stuff. Essentially, the only thing that really needed specifying, as far as I'm concerned, is the differentiation of Rock Band Pro songs, buying them without the Pro Guitar and Pro Bass upgrade versus adding that Pro Guitar and Pro Bass upgrade. Anyway, there you go. Hope it helps, and all the best.